My name is Andrew Stewart. I'm testifying in favor of 2244, 2476, 2247. So we've heard a couple times. I'm a substitute teacher in Providence for the last 2 years. I've been working at the intersection of Eddy and Thurber's Avenue, but those two schools, Roger Williams and Juanita Sanchez, doing mostly English as a secondary language class, but other classes too as a sub. The reason I mention that is that's a high poverty population. Lots and lots of kids I work with don't have the basic necessities. We had to do a coat drive really impromptu around Christmas time when we had the cold snap. We have a substantial high number, probably in the 80 or 90 percentile of free and reduced lunch and breakfast program. So you've heard a couple times today that if you don't raise the wage, it's just gonna come back out the other side in terms of government service. That's gonna make up the gap that parents aren't able to fill. It's worth pointing out, I have no problems with my lunch ladies. They're awesome, they're very nice to me. They let me do as I please, but the food that they serve is not high quality food. You probably wouldn't want to eat it if you were served Armac food at one of your gatherings here. You'd probably kind of send it back, because that's what happens when you don't put this into the hands of the parents. It's put onto the hands of a privatized service like Armac, and you know, those are the results you get. Right here, we're talking about also costs. So maybe some of you saw a couple years ago, I think it was last year, there was a news story on Channel 12 about how Mayor Elorza has to keep in mind when he's gonna have a snow day, whether or not the kids in the school district are gonna get fed that day because of the number of kids that depend on free and reduced lunch and breakfast programs, as well as after school programs that include snacks. So while kids in Warwick and East Greenwich get to go have a sleigh ride and have a snow day and drink hot cocoa, you gotta get the plows out and open the roads up in Providence because you need kids able to eat. That's another expense compounding on top of the service. So by increasing the minimum wage for the parents of the kids I'm seeing in schools, you're reducing a serious expense to a city that we all know already is dealing with a very difficult municipal budget in the red. And you know, the challenges I see and have to deal with every day as a result of not having sufficient funding and resources in my school buildings, you know, you wouldn't accept it for your kids. I've got oversized classrooms. I've got kids who belong in different setting, whether it be a different level that they got shoved into one cohort with other kids that are above them, but hey, it's a way to cut dollars. Or maybe they're just not being given proper medical evaluation for things like special education needs and that sort of stuff. By raising the wages of the parents of my students, you're reducing a significant amount of the challenges I'm facing in the classroom every day. So, you know, I have a lot of respect and sympathy for what happened in Florida, and I understand the emotions that were evoked by it. I saw the lobby action going on today with the gun violence activists, and I understand that. But, you know, childhood poverty is a systemic form of violence that happens every day in this state. And it's much more degrading and much more painful thing to deal with because it's day in and day out. Whereas, well, what happened in Florida was truly reprehensible and really cannot be given any sort of pardon. It's a one-time flash in the pan as compared to what you see day in and day out. So I wanted to just briefly touch on what I do after work, because on Fridays, I'll hop on the highway.
Andrew, can you just Focus off to the bill instead of our bills.
Well, certainly, because I go to Greg's after work. And that gentleman's restaurant in Warwick, where I've been living my entire life, has expanded significantly since I've been living there. He's now got two parking lots. His service is one of the most modern and well-equipped restaurants in the entire state. So I, in all honesty, have to be very clear. This kind of poor me attitude and the whining from business owners, I don't see that from real poor people. So I really have no sympathy for that sort of whining. But thank you very much for your time.